Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Grade Up. My name is Dinesh Singh, and we are continuing with the yesterday's class, and this is the general aptitude class 3rd. We have done yesterday 13 questions, so I'm proceeding further from there. Okay, so this is my introduction, so you can see the slide. I'm not going to tell something more. Okay, and we have started a course. This is for the Mega Mock Challenge. So this is a free test, free mock test, which is open on 29th of the, means today it is open at 12 PM and it would be till tomorrow you can take the test. So means just check your preparation, take this test. Okay, and these are the live analysis. Once you are done with the examination, you can see. So mechanical bow shift we will take at the 9 PM on the 1st February, electronics. So you can just take the screenshot of this part. So you'll get the notification of these also if you have subscribed to our channel or you are registered to our Grade Up site. Okay, so these are the questions which we have done yesterday. I think this was the last question we have done. Now I am proceeding for 14 numbers, so I am just giving you 1 minute, so just putting a timer. So everybody, so please take your time and try to solve this question. So everyone, please try. So I'm putting a timer of 2 minutes. If you can solve this one. Aaj mixture will be come. So we will start with some mixture allegation question also. Engineering maths ke sakshi chal rahe hain video. So we are also putting the engineering mathematics video, okay. Aaj mixture allegation bhi hai, aaj compound interest bhi hai. So don't worry about that, that is a work problem. Okay, good. Hani Singh has given the answer. Very good. Rajesh Ranjan, hi. B Bombay net error. Okay, Sakshi. So refresh it because we are checking the live also, we are getting the same thing. Nehar Atod, hello. Anything, that's fine. We are getting the answer 35, okay. So now, so let's see what is the, this is a question of the negative work. So what we will say, so the negative work concept says, suppose we are saying there is a, this is a similar to a monkey question. You have seen many times the monkey puzzle. Suppose this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So suppose somebody says a monkey can go 3 meter in 1 second, in first second, and then monkey goes 2 meter down in second second. So when he will reach at the top? So basically question says it is a, they are working alternatively. So first second he is going 3 meter up and the second second he is going 2 meter down. So we will say in 2 seconds monkey will go 1 meter up. Okay. Now don't write 2 into 10, that would be give 20 minutes, which is a wrong answer. Why? Because whenever is a monkey at 7 step, okay, why we are taking 7? Because the monkey's jump is what? 3 meter. So means whenever at 7 meter, he will take one jump of 3 meter and he will reach at the top. So we are saying till 7 meter, he will take how much time? We are saying 14 seconds. And then next 1 second, he will complete the 10 meter. Okay, so this is the concept of negative work. So we are saying in 15 seconds, he will reach the top. So same question is there. We are saying in 1, if we take, he made 3 meter in 1 day and break 2 meter in 2nd day. So means in 2 days, the wall is made as 1 meter. Now you have to make what? First time. First time means 20 meter. So whenever the wall is made at 17 meter, the next day A will come and complete the wall. So if you are saying in 2 days 1 meter, so definitely in 7 meter would be in 34 days. So in 34 days it would be 17 meter. So next day, it will give you 35 meters. So answer is what? C, Chennai. Is that clear? Okay. Chaliye. So this is the answer. This is the negative work. So hamesha rakhiye, whenever you are going for the negative question, negative work, always remember alternate days. Okay. What is galat hai? Kya galat hai aapka? Science lover, your answer is galat? Okay. So try the next one. So don't worry, science it lovers, it is perfectly fine. You check yours, okay. Shakshi, just try to solve this question. ये मंकी टाइप का पजल होता है कि मंकी इन 1 second मंकी गोज अप 3 meter, इन 2nd second मंकी गो डाउन बाय 2 meter. सो इफ देयर इज अ 10 meter वॉल, व्हेन ही विल रीच एज द टॉप, अगर 10 meter का आप आंसर निकाल लेंगे तो देन ट्राई फॉर द 20 meter, और 20 meter का आंसर ही दैट द आंसर ऑफ द लास्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके, now try this one. SS group, what is the issue with the language? Can you tell me? You cannot understand my language. Honey Singh, good. They are working alternate day. Can't you read this thing? You are not reading properly. Just read it properly, then only you can answer the aptitude question, science lover. Normal, it is very easy. If you are saying they are working every day, then the answer would be 20, not 18. Okay. So if they are working together, means 3 meter wall is built and the 2 meter is broken. So finally 1 meter in a day. So 20 days would be the answer if they are working together. But if they are working alternate, then you have to check this one. let's see, this is the interest formula. It's fine, don't worry about it. Everybody please reply this question. And I have seen so many answers. D is coming. Okay, they are saying the compound interest on a sum of 2 years is ₹832. As a simple interest on the same sum of the same period is ₹800. The difference between the compound interest and the simple interest for 3 years. Okay. Now somebody asked me how to calculate the compound interest. Now I am telling you very simple method. So we are saying, suppose I am writing this one. Okay. Then I will solve this question. So I am taking an example to calculate the compound interest, because most of the time they ask for the 2 year or 3 year. Nobody is going to ask you for the 10 year. Then there will be different formula. So suppose we are saying principal is given as ₹1,000, or we are saying ₹10,000. Okay, rate of interest per year, because generally it is given as per year. So we are saying per year. Okay, now we are saying what you have to calculate. Suppose somebody asks you, this is the amount. So we are saying principal is what? 10,000. Okay, now I will calculate the simple interest, then I will calculate the compound interest. Okay, now simple interest for 1 year, simple interest for 2 year, simple interest for 3 year. Let's see how we will calculate. We will say simple interest would 1 year would be 10%, that would be 1,000. So compound interest would be also 1,000, because there is no interest over which you are calculating the interest. Okay, so let's see, the first year it is same. For the second year, compound interest would be again 1,000, and third year also it would be 1,000. So there is no change in the simple interest, because simple interest for single year is always same. Okay, so what we are saying, so simple interest for each year is same. Now coming to the compound interest, we will say interest on interest. So second year we will get the interest on this amount, so that would be what, 10% of this is ₹100. Okay, why? Because we are saying, because it is a 10% of the given part. Now for 2 year, because this is the accumulated interest, so 10% of these would be ₹200. So that's why the people say always do the double of this one. Let's see. But this is the extra amount we are saying. So 10% of this would be what? ₹10. Clear what I am saying? For first year, compound interest and simple interest is same. For second year, so this is the second year, is ₹1,100. Okay. Now for the third year only, it is what? 1,210. Okay. So first year, it is 1,000. Now, if somebody asks you to calculate for the fourth year also, we can do. So it would be 1,000 only. Now this would be what? 3,000. So it would be ₹300. Now this is what? Total amount is what? ₹300. So we will get ₹30 of this one. And this would be what? ₹1. So if you see, this would be what? 1331 for third year. Clear? So this is the best way to calculate. Now, if somebody asks you, what is the compound interest for combined 2 year? So let's see, how we will do that. So I am saying, so simple interest for 2 year would be, simple interest for 2 year is nothing but 2,000. For compound interest for 2 year would be, this is the amount. Okay, so that would be what? 2,100. For 3 year, it would be the total. Okay, so 3 year, it would be what? 3,310. For 4 year also you can calculate, that would be what? 4,441. So we'll say 4,441. Clear? This is the way you will calculate. Now I am coming to the question, how to calculate. Let's see. So please write down, this is the best way to calculate. If somebody asks you the difference, we will say the difference for 2 year is ₹100. Difference for 2 year is what? ₹310. Difference for 3 year is this one. Sakshi, it's your wish. Okay, I am just explaining, that's why it is taking time. Now let's see, how will you solve? I am not going for any formula. I will solve every question using that one. So please write down. Now I am coming to the question. So your question says what? We are saying first year and second year. Let's see how fast we can do. This is a SI, this is a CI we want to calculate. Okay, we are saying 800 rupees is what? Your SI. So means definitely 400 for first, 400 for second year. Now we are saying 32 is extra. Why? Because the CI is this one. Now this is what? 32 is what percent? We will say 8%. Clear? So that is 8%. Now we will say whatever we will write, 62, and 8% of this would be what? 32 into 8. This is 256. So 2.56. Now what they are asking? The difference between 3 years, add these number. What you will get? 64, 32 is 96 and 98.56. This is my answer. Clear? You use your formula, I am doing directly. Everyone, so let's see what is my answer. 98.56. So how did I do that? I am saying for 800 rupees is the SI. So per year it is 400. Now what is the CI? We are saying 32 rupees. So 32 is what percent of 400? It is 8%. So we are saying this total is what? Now this total is 800. So 800, 8% is what? 64, and 8% of this is what? 2.56. I am good, Rajni. So please write down this thing. So this is for the CI problem. And the formula, if you want to calculate the formula, CI is what? P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to power T minus P. So this is the formula you have to say. And somebody says you, the SI and CI for 2 year minus SI for 2 year. So formula is what? P into R by 100 raised to power 2. Okay, so this way also you can calculate. Now try this one, everybody, and tell me the answer. Everyone, this is a geometry question. Please try and give me the answer. Lower part is not seen. So this is written as A, D, E. Okay, is that okay now? Try everybody and tell me the answer. Refresh कीजिए, मेरे पास buffering problem नहीं, I am not having any buffering problem because I can see online also, I am seeing live also, both the, 6 is the answer, okay fine. So B Bombay 6 is coming as the answer for many people. So let's see, I am giving you one more minute and then I will start with the question. Centimeter, fine. I don't. Okay, let's see. Just remember, if they are similar figure, okay, in 2D as well as in 3D. Similar figure means their corresponding angles are equal and the corresponding sides are in ratio. So just remember, the area ratio is what? The square of ratio of their side. And whenever there is a 3D figure, we will say surface area is always the square of the ratio of side, and the volume is always equal to the ratio of volumes 1 versus volume 2 is always the cube of ratio of their side. So whenever there is a similar figure and the similar figure in 2D as well as 3D. Now what they are saying, D is parallel to BE, so means this angle and this angle is same. This angle is same, and this is common to both. So we are saying triangle ADE and triangle ABE are similar. So if we talk about the area of ADE versus area of ABE, that would be the ratio of their square of the ratio of their side. So this is given as what? ADE is 9. And this is given as 7. So means this total area is 16. So we are saying this is given as 9 upon 16. So the ratio of their side would be what? 3 is to 4. So means now they are saying D is equal to 3 centimeter. So definitely it would be the 4 times. So it would be 4 centimeter. So my answer is D, Delhi. Most of the people have given 6, which is absolutely wrong. Okay. So answer is B, D, Delhi, which is a 4 centimeter. So please check this one. Clear? One more question similar to this I am giving to you, and tell me the answer for that one also. Okay, is that clear? The square, because we are saying area ratio would be always the square of ratio of their sides. So let's see, I am drawing a figure. Suppose there is a cone. Okay. Now we are saying cone is cut by two plane. So the plane P1 versus plane P2 parallel to base. This is your base, which is a circle. Now we are saying, suppose this is a height, and we are saying suppose they are cutting at A, B, C, D. So we are saying this is AB versus BC versus CD is equal to 1:1:1. Now what we are saying, you have to calculate the volume 1, which is what? This part. And the volume 2 is this part. And volume 3 is this part. So what is the ratio of their volume? So you have to tell me the ratio of their volume if they are cut by a plane which is parallel to bases, and this is what? 1:1:1. Clear, everybody? Just try to solve this one. I am giving you 2 minutes. Hani Singh, don't be in hurry. Your answer is wrong. So that is a basic concept of the similarity. If two figures are similar, their perimeter is always in the ratio of their side. Their area is always square of their side. Okay. Hani Singh, it is wrong. Science lover, again it is wrong. You people are doing so fast, that's why you are doing wrong. Tetrahedron, we are saying there is a top which is known as a vertex, and there is a equilateral triangle, and join this with this. So there are three surfaces which are all equilateral triangle, then we know it is a tetrahedron. Okay, if this area, this area, this area, so there are exactly four surfaces. One is a base, three is the, so that is known as a tetrahedron. Okay, so this is the case of the, so we say there are two figures, one is a prism, one is a pyramid. So this is the case of the pyramid. So let's see now. So we are saying, suppose this is the figure 1 and this is what, second figure, and this is what we are saying. So we are saying there are three figures. First is what? This one. Second is this one, and third is this one. So the ratio of their side is what? There are three cube cone. So we are saying the ratio of their height is 1:2, 2:3. So volume of the one part, which is we are saying volume of the second part and the volume of the third part, would be 1:8:27. But what I have asked, we are saying this is the volume 1. So this is 1 and this total is 8. So definitely this would be 7. Why? Because we are saying this width V1 versus V2 is total what? V2 dash. Now this total is what? 27. V1 and V2 is what? 8. So that is what? 27 minus 8, which is equal to 19. So we are saying this is 19 part, this is 7 part, this is 1 part. So my answer is what? 1:7:19. So that is a correct answer. Nobody has given this answer. Not 20, it is 19. Why? Because we are saying this is 1, this is 7. So 1 plus 7 is 8 and total is 27. So 27 minus 8 is 19. Is that clear? 1:8:27 is wrong, 1:2:3 is wrong. So this is the correct answer. We are not talking about the total volume. We are talking about the this part only. Okay, let's try this one and tell me the answer, everybody. Durgesh, just go to our SSC channel. There you will find the mensuration class. There we have explained everything. Okay, we have explained the pyramid as well as the prism cases. Okay, so I am taking the specific question here. Okay, so that's why let me finish all the questions which are given to me. Otherwise, tetrahedron is a apex vertex. There is a triangle which is an equilateral triangle. You join the corner with top, then we will say there is perimeter, there is slant height, then there is what? Lateral surface area, all these things. Yes, definitely, Anish Singh, this is the correct one. Okay, and the people who are saying, we are saying this is what? Suppose there is a first one, 1 versus 1 versus 1. So means total this is 2 and total this is 3. So total volume this would be what? 1 and this would be what? 8 and this would be what? 27. So this is 1 part. This is what? Total is 8 part. So if this is 1 part in volume, so this would be 7 part and total is 27. So this would be 19 part. So that we have done. Yes, very good, Akash Singh. Swati and Shahrukh has given the correct answer. Very good. This is a very simple question. Generally, we say whenever somebody asks this type of question, 1 upon x is equal to what given as value a. So just square that, you will get x square plus 1 by x square plus 2 is equal to a square. So means we will get x square. So similar way, we will calculate what? We will say 10 square a plus cot square a plus 2 is equal to 4 square. So means 10 square a plus cot square a is equal to 14. Now square of this one, it would be 10 4a plus cot 4a plus 2 is equal to 196. So they are asking this value, so it would be 196 minus 2. So that would be what? 194. So D, Delhi, is the correct answer for this question. Okay. let's try this one. Again giving you, this is a percentage question. So just refresh. So C is the answer, C, 2, 2, 2, 2, we are saying, okay. Very good, very good. Akash says D, Delhi, very good. What is great? Shabrinath Gupta. Science lover says 100. Rachis says 100 and Shahrukh says 2, Shahwar Pravas says 4, okay, very good. Riya Lad says 100, okay, let's see, I have, so we are saying first, there are 200 fishes, so there are only two colors. We are saying red and the others. So red and others. And total we know initial cases, they are 200. So 99% are red, so it is 198. Now we are saying others are 2. Now what we are saying, how many red fish must be removed? So we don't know how many we have to remove. But we are saying the reduce that the percentage of the red fish becomes to 98. So that should be 98%. Here it is 99%, and how did we calculate? Because we know the actual. So percentage is always calculated over basis. So we don't know how many we have removed, but we know the others are 2 only. If this is 90%, this would be 2%. So now because this has changed, so we can not calculate the base using that. But if you use this one, because this is 2%, so we are saying 2% of what is equal to 2. So that is, we are saying 100. So means now the number of fishes should be 100. So such that this is 2. So this is 2%. So remaining is 98%. So we will say there should be 98 fishes. So red would be 198 to 98. How many we have to reduce? That is what? 100. So that is your answer. And the people who are putting any other answer, let's see, just check. We are saying initially there are 200. This is 198. This is 2. Just remove 2. So it would be 196. It would be 2. It would be 198. Is it 98%? No, which is wrong. You can put by the values also. If you say 10, we will say if we remove 10, it would be 188. It would be what? 2. It would be 190. Is this 98%? Again, no. If we remove 50, what you will get? It would be 148, it would be 2, it would be 150. Is it 98%? No. So by option also you can get the answer. Clear? Because we don't know the final base. So final base, but this value is same. So this value is, earlier it was 1%, now it is 2%. So 2% of what is equal to 2? We will say 100 would be the actual after removing the red fishes. Okay. Now try this one. This is a mixture allegation type of question. So somebody asked me to calculate for the mixture allegation. So I am just writing the mixture allegation question. Everybody take 2 minutes and try to solve this question. So one more minute and you can solve then. So I'm not getting the answer of anyone. B, Bombay is the answer for science lover. Good. Fine, we have seen 112 liter. Okay, fine. Akash Singh says 128. Abhishek says 112. Okay, let's see. Just read the question one by one. We are saying 3/4 of the part of a tank. So we are saying 3/4 of the capacity. So tank capacity, we are saying 3/4. Filled with the water, 50% of the water is removed. So 50% means 1 by 2. Now, 3 by 8 is the water. Okay. Now we are saying 60 liter of the pure milk is added. Now the ratio of the milk is to water. So water is 60 liter. We don't know about the milk, but they are saying the ratio is 5:4. So if this is 5:4 means 5 part is equal to 60 liter. So means this is a 12 times. So again this should be 12 times. So milk should be 48 liter. Sorry, milk not water, because milk is. So we says milk versus water is given as this. So water should be 48 liter. But we are saying water is a 3/8 of the total capacity. So if 3/8 capacity is equal to 48 liter, so the full capacity would be what? 8/3. So that would be 16 × 8, which would be 128 liter. So just solve step by step, you will get the answer. So B, Bombay is the correct answer. Okay. So this is the answer for this one. Let's see one more question on the mixture allegation and try to solve it. I am giving you 1 minute, sorry, 2 minutes. Logarithm is important. CERT पे generally कोई question आया नहीं है और बहुत simple से question आए. I will not say, because gate का syllabus ऐसा नहीं है. You can't say the gate cannot ask anything. Gate can ask anything. Okay, there is no predefined syllabus. They say numerical accuracy, which is a very general statement. Okay. So आप you cannot cover the entire syllabus of the gate, because we are saying just read the journal syllabus, and most of the things we are saying you know these things already. Okay, so basic of arithmetic you should know, basic geometry you should know, and then you can solve the questions. Okay, now let's see 20 more seconds and then you can solve this one. Pehlad, by practicing the previous year question, you will get an idea, okay? You don't have to devote the time for everything, okay? Because it is a general aptitude, they assume if you don't know anything, then also you can calculate the 10, you can get the 10 marks at least, okay? So that's why they are saying general aptitude. So let's see what they are saying. There are three samples in the ratio of 2:1. First sample, milk is to water. Second is what? 3:2. Then it is 5:3. Now they are saying the mixture comprising equal quantity. But remember, if somebody add these things, we will say 5, 3, 7, 2, 9, and 6. That is absolutely wrong because they are not equal. This is nothing but 3 part. This is nothing but 5 part. This is nothing but 8 part. So how they will make equal? So we are saying this is total 3 part. This is total is 5 part. This is total is what? 8 part. So you have to take the LCM of this. So what is the meaning of that? If you multiply this with 5 into 8, you will get this is a equal. Here you have to multiply what? This is a 5 part. Multiply this with 3 into 8, and this 5 into 3. So let's see what you will get. Here we will get 8140. That is equal to 120 part total. Here we will say 24 into 3 is 72 versus what? 48. Again it is 120. So now they are equal. This is what? 15 into 5 is 75 versus this is what? 45. Again they are 120. So always remember, whenever they are saying the equal quantity, you have to make the ratios equal. So they are not equal. Just take the LCM and try to solve. Okay, now just add these. So this is 80, 70 and 70. This is equal to 227. Now the remaining is what? 40, 40, 120 and 13 is what? 133. So this is my answer, C, Chennai. Is that clear, everybody? And another way also, that should be the total is 360. So which is giving you 360? This is not giving 360. This is not giving 360, this is not giving 360, but first part is what? So you have to check between these two. Okay, and definitely in every part, the first is a milk is more. Milk is more, milk is more. So definitely this would be out. So milk would be more. So answer is C, Chennai, for this one. Try this one. Again, this is a very popular question. Giving you 2 minutes. And this is a CAT 2004 question, and in GATE there are so many questions which are previously asked in the CAT examination. So this is one of the very popular question of the CAT. So let's see, waiting for the reply from everyone. C is the answer for many people. So So let's see how you solve. Just take the screenshot of the question. I'm telling you very simple way to solve this question. Now this is a very popular type of question. We are saying, suppose this is a tunnel. Okay. Now train is approaching from this side. Okay. We are saying this is a train. Okay. So we are saying, suppose the length of this is the 3/8. So we will say this is a 8D is the distance. And this is A part and this is a B part. So we are saying cat is here. So this distance is 3D. Okay. Now we are saying, if cat is running in the direction and train is coming from this direction, so we will say, so first time we are talking about the T1, when they are reaching, so train is here and cat is also here. Okay, we are saying cat is here. So this is the T1 time. So means cat is traveled as 3D distance. Now we are saying, if the case is second, so this is what? Second case. So we are saying the cat is taking the time is what? So at T1 time, train is here and cat is also here. But if it is running in the opposite direction, so same time T1, we will say cat would travel the distance 3D. So cat would be in this place if they are running in the opposite direction. So I am taking two cases simultaneously. So at time T1, we are talking about train is here and cat is here. So cat is traveling what? Already travels 6D distance at T1 time. Now they are saying at T2, both are reaching at the second end, which is B. So now we are saying they are starting at T1 time and at T2 time. So means time is same. So whenever we say time is constant or time is same, then distance is directly proportional to the speed. Because time formula is distance upon the speed 1. So we are saying distance upon the speed 2. So let's see how much the train will travel. So train will travel 8D. And the cat will travel what? 2D. So means what is the ratio of their speed? So speed of train would be 8D. Speed of the cat would be what? 4D. So 2D. So the ratio of this would be 4:1. So that is a very simple question. Okay, so answer is 4:1. Clear? So 4:1. Now you can say directly whatever is written. Suppose somebody says this is what? 3/9. Can we solve? Yes. Your answer would be what? Or we'll say 3/19. Whatever you want to write. So means if we say 3 is this one. So next time it would be what? 19 would be the train. And cat would be 19-6. So that is your answer. Similarly, we have written 3/8. So your answer is what? 8 × 8 − 3 × 2. So this way you can solve any question. Okay, this type of question. So 4:1 is the correct answer. Clear? I hope this is clear to everyone. So because it will travel, cat will travel 3 and 3, 6. So 19-6 for the cat. And the train will travel the complete. Try this one. Again, very easy question. So let's see, I am giving you 1 minute for this question. Because I have to solve 3 more questions. So I will give you only 1 minute for this question, everybody. B, Bombay, very good, 160 km. 120, Hani Singh. So let's see, 10 more seconds. So we are saying, suppose the distance is constant. So we are saying distance is constant. So S1 T1 is equal to S2 T2. So S1 upon S2 would be what? T2 upon T1. So S2 is what? 24 upon 30. So time would be what? T2 upon T1 would be what? We are saying 4 versus 4 is to 5 T2. Okay. So means the gap of the time is given as one part. So now here it would be 4 hours and the later it would be what? 5 hours. So means in second speed we are saying T2 you are taking 4 hours. So means if you are going 30 kilometer with the 4 hours you will travel 120 kilometer. Or either 24 kilometer with the 5 hours, in 5 hours you will travel 120. So 120 is the correct answer for this one. Okay. कहाँ पहुँच रहे हो आप? 20th LCM, आप 20th पे कहाँ रुक गए आप लोग? भाई ये लिखा है 3 part, ये लिखा है 5 part, it is 8 part, so LCM of that is 120, not 20. Because this is 3 part, this is 5 part, 8 part, all should be equal. So if you multiply by any ratio, you will get the no change in the ratio. Now this is a very simple question, I am giving you again 1 minute to solve this question. The minimum value of cos x square plus cos y square minus cos square z. Not zero. We are saying the angle are different. So the minimum value of this one is zero. Minimum value is this is zero. Minimum value is this what? Minus 1. Why? Because we want to calculate the maximum value of cos square z. So, answer is A, Ahmedabad. Clear? It is not plus, it is minus. If somebody says plus, then we will say it is a 0. So, minus 1 is the correct answer because cos square z, if z is equal to 0, x is equal to pi by 2, y equal to pi by 2, you will get this answer. Okay? So, A is minus 1. So try this one, again giving you 1 minute. So I am just drawing the figure, we are saying bulging. So if you go there, then the angle of this is 30 degree, this would be what? 15 degree. And both of the point on the same side, if the distance between these two points are 48. So this is given as 48. So they are saying find the height of the building, we have to calculate this value. So let's see, I am giving you 1 minute. Very good, Rachit. So always remember, in most of the time, there are two type of angle. Suppose we are saying this is 30 degree. Suppose this is 30 degree, this is 60 degree and this is 90 degree. So if the ratio of, sorry, angle are 30, 60 and 90, so the corresponding sides are in the ratio of 1 is to root 3. And if there is a 45, 45, 90, the ratio of the opposite side is 1 is to 1 is to root 2. This is a very popular statement in the case of the angle of elevation. Okay, let's see now this question. I am starting because more than 1 minute is there. Okay, 24 root 3. What? We are saying because this is given as 15 degree, this is 30 degree. So we are saying because this is the exterior angle of this ACB. So this will be again 15 degree. Why? Because sum of the... Now this is 15, this is 15, so opposite side should be equal. So this angle is what? 40. Sorry, this length is 48. Now this is 30, this is 90 degree, this is 60. So using the ratio opposite of 30 is what? K. Opposite of 60 would be root 3K. And this would be what? 2K. So 2K given as 48, so K would be given as 24. So what they are asking, what is the height of the building that is at 24? So this is the way you can solve. There is no need to write any angle 10 theta 10 45. Clear? Again repeating, this is the exterior angle which is a sum of two interior angles. So if this is 15, this would be 15. Now since they are equal, so it is an isosceles triangle. So opposite side should be same length. So this is 48, so this would be 48. Now in this case, 30, 60, 90, the ratio of opposite side is a 1 is to root 3 is to 2. So 2k is equal to 48, so k would be 24. So answer is A, Ahmedabad. Okay. Yeah, again write A. Very good. So this is the last question. Okay, and whenever you are doing this type of question, try to make this figure. We are saying this is A, B, C. So again giving you 1 minute and then we will finish it. Who is wrong? You are wrong or we are wrong? Funtech, you are saying wrong. Who is wrong? Let's see, the formula says NA union B union C is equal to NA plus NB plus NC minus NA intersection B minus B intersection C minus C intersection A plus NA intersection B intersection C. Okay. So both are the wrong. Now they are saying in a society, every family has at least one of the three species. So this is 100%. So I am saying 100. NA given is 70%. NB is given as 55%. NC is given at 40%. And these three are not given. So we are saying plus. Remaining is 15%. So means we are getting what? NA intersection B plus NB intersection C plus NC intersection A is equal to what? This is 70, this is 70, 140, this is equal to 80%. Now don't write 80%, that is absolutely wrong answer. So what we have to do, because this is what? The common part D plus G. This is what? E plus G. This is what? F plus G is equal to 80%. Now what you want? You want the exactly two dog species, that is a D, E, F. So D, E, F we have to calculate. So remove 3 times of the G. And G is already given as 15%. So your answer would be 18 minus 45, which is equal to 35% of total. Clear? So most of the people give the 80%, which is wrong. So C Chinna is the correct answer. It is not 40. Okay. So this is all about the today's class. So thank you very much. Thanks for attending the class. We have started a Vision 2021 course, and that is for the ESC and the GATE aspirant. There would be live classes, everything would be there. So please join that course if you want to study seriously for the GATE and the ESC examination. And that you can go for the free trial. Okay, and you can see the quality of the lectures. And there is a discount for the scholarship discount for the GATE qualified. So means this is open after the GATE examination also. All NIT government students. So we take the screenshot of this part. For any information, you can call either this number or you can drop us a mail or just write down on the Anand Pandey, anand.pandey@gradeup.co. Okay. And the green card is for the 12th month subscription for the all type of examination. Okay. So you can join this. So thank you very much, everybody. Thanks for attending the class.